All right, to practice making your limbs all super fancy, we've got our hipster man set up here with all of his rigging done except for the arms. The arms are totally raw. The only things that have been done is the hand comps are set up with their replacement sequences. There's no time remapping or controllers, but inside those comps we have our sequences of hands. And the hand and upper and lower arm all have their anchor points set on the left and right arm. But other than that, there's been no rigging done here. We have our controllers in place. Those are created for you, but they haven't been rigged in. And we have some props here as well that also have been positioned but have not been rigged. So the first thing you're going to do is get the arms rigged up. Now you want to use one of two techniques, either puppet tool the entire arm, so pre-compose the upper and lower arm together and then puppet tool that, or you're going to do a blended joint where you puppet tool the upper and lower arm together. But you have to choose one or the other, because what I want you to do as you rig up these arms is I want you to add auxiliary elbow control to both arms. So it has to be either a puppet tooled arm or a blended joint arm. Now your elbow control can either be with a point controller or a click and drag controller if you wish. That's up to you. And then along with the auxiliary elbow control, you're going to add a hand selector to be able to select the different hand poses, particularly the fifth hand pose, which is on frame 50, which has the mask that knocks out the thumb so it looks like he's holding the props. And we also want to add shoulder controls to both arms. Once the arms and the hand are rigged up, then I want you to rig the three props with a replacement rig just like we did for the orange man, so you can select between the three props. The props have already, all three, been aligned to perfectly line up with the mask knocking out his thumb on that fifth hand pose. They're already in the right position here in the rig comp, so all you're going to need to do is duplicate one of these layers to use as a guide, pre-compose the other three, and then crop and realign that so that once again it lines up right with the edge of that thumb on the fifth hand pose. Now remember to pre-compose the props twice, because we're also going to have you add level swapping to both arms, including the prop layer. So remember, that means that you're going to want to pre-compose the props twice. So in the base comp, you have the replacement sequence, and in the next pre-comp up, you're going to add your time remapping and your opacity control to turn the props on and off. And you're also going to add offset and rotation control to the props, again like we did on the orange man. All of that is going to take place in that pre-comp in between the rig comp and the base comp where you have the replacement sequence. So you're really building arms here with all the bells and whistles that we've talked about. Hand selector, shoulder control, elbow control, prop selector, prop offset and rotate, and then level swapping for both arms as well. Now that'll be your biggest task here for the exercise, but we also have our suit man here, and the right arm here is left where we left it at the end of the last lesson, with the rotation morph working really nice there. And what we want you to do here is do the same thing for the left arm, and you can see that the left arm needs that rotation morphing as well, but this time rather than setting it up to rotate backwards, we have to focus on rotating this forwards and pulling this point back here so we reconnect the arm with the torso. So it's the same problem, just kind of in reverse. So rotation morphs are fairly tricky, so I'll give you a couple of tips since I had to create the solution file for this and I already worked with it some. Note that on this arm, we're getting that plus 360 that we get sometimes. And remember, when we did the one in the lesson, we were able to ignore that and just enter zero when we added the rotation morph minimum rotation value. However, when I did this arm, that didn't work, and I had to do the 1 rotation times 0 degrees, which is actually what it'll jump to if you type in plus 360 anyway. But I had to actually add that to that minimum value to make this work. And it again just underlines the unpredictability of the rotation morph when you're using it with an IK system. So again, in this case, I had to add that 1 rotation times 0 degrees to the minimum value, and then the maximum value I just entered as it appeared there on the layer. Now also be aware that when I had to correct the IK limit in order to keep the shape from popping, I had to correct this clockwise, positive degrees, rather than counterclockwise, negative degrees, which is what we had to do in the lesson. And I think that's just because we're literally swinging the other direction. So just a couple of tips there. Now, I can't even guarantee for sure that those tips will work for you when you do this yourself. You might do something a little different than what I did, and it could change that equation. I, again, am not enough of a math whiz to totally get it. I know how to make it work with some fiddling and some trial and error. Oh, and I should also say that the rotation numbers that I used for the minimum and maximum limit were the numbers generated when the arm orientation was set counterclockwise with this unchecked. So those numbers seem to work for me. And again, I can't guarantee that they will work for you 100%, but at least it's a good place to start. And please remember again, we are focusing on arms all the way through this lesson, but every single one of these techniques can be done on a leg or even on a finger or another appendage or limb. All of these techniques will really make you a limb ninja when you are dealing with complicated animation and difficult rigging situations. As always, once you're done, compare your work to the solution file we've provided.